guys here we are. Filling up our 43-foot and 18-foot dolly with barley. We're gonna have a great demand tomorrow. Get out of the truck here. You can see that we're pulling it's like 900 and some odd liters of barley. I was gonna do it yesterday with Mike, but we had a glitch in one of the cell points, so. This rig fully loaded, ready to go. And just gonna use Follow Me mod to get it done, because round trip won't take that long. So we're at 72,240. I think this trailer spec'd at like 1200 bushels. The pump trailer spec'd at like 650. With a 10 inch at a 10 inch heap, which is per Wilson trailer specs. I put in timed doors and triggers on this map now, so pretty much everything opens at 6 o'clock and closes at 6 o'clock or 1800 hours. So this truck is 13. That around a distance that's more manageable. So also redid the beet piler. Before it was just kind of just Lego built out of maybe a couple hundred components. So what I did is I just combined all of those into one. Now it's just one object with a nice AO on it and a lot less polygons. So that should be a lot better. Finished putting in a lot of power lines. Put power lines all on the back roads now, and then up over there by the Conagra, and in those big roads over there by 8, along 30 and 8 and 9 and 16. So looks a lot better over there, and then I finished it all the way up to the bale cell. So looks a lot nicer now. So I'm just gonna go ahead and accelerate time here. We have a great demand at 9 o'clock. Converted these pump trailers are all nice and washable, and then the 36 was just kind of a it's the same texture and everything as the 43 foot, but just shortened it in Blender using that, so keeping Raphael's nice textures. So I had to drive a little bit more judiciously with Follow Me mod and the Ascending truck. So I put lines down this road and then down this next road. Just kind of dress it up a little bit, get that more finished look. So we're burning up about 20,000 a day in between land leases and interest. Operating costs and equipment. So I was posting pictures of my Wilson trailers loaded up with like 86 or like 90,000 liters, and just watching people's math is kind of horrendous. One guy came up with like 186,000 pounds. It's like, dude, you can't convert a liter, assuming it's a kilogram, to pounds. No, you have to find out the density of material, because this is based on liters, and you need to know the density per volume of whatever you're putting in. So you convert the liter to a bushel, then you find the constant that is corn density per bushel, which is about 56 pounds per bushel on average, and then you can multiply that figure into how many bushels you have. Okay, we have to wait a little bit, and then we're going to get ourselves big payday in barley. Woo! So we're at 116,000. 116,000 dollars. Alright guys, are you ready for it? Are you ready for it? It would be Old Grain Mill. Right now we're at 356. And we go on the map. So at that rate, what should we be getting at? Too bad. Is there 17 again? Back on our cutters. I plowed it up 34 too, so that's looking nice. I So now we have to do about 6 or 7 more trips like that. So overall, not too far of a drive. Wish I didn't have to use Follow Me mod, but what can you do? The 236 Ford in a tandem dolly. Actually, it handles a lot better. It holds like 10,000 more liters, so I think I'm definitely gonna go that route. Even if I were to have a third axle in the truck, it probably wouldn't this one handle it as nicely. So. Usually only care about that when we're putting grain in. Having issues with triggers on the server lately, which is really weird. I like this glance mod because I can like hide all my HUDs and still see what the fill levels and such are, and the other trucks are. I can see what sprayers are if I'm running the tender trailer. See what combine levels are. So this little T600's got its work cut out for it, hauling this heavy load. I was playing around with it in the dual 36 footers. It was like the little engine that could. Some of these hilly roads could only get up to like 40 miles an hour. So. We'll have a bigger cat truck soon enough, as soon as I finish in game. Yeah. Gonna have animated doors and windows and IC functions and stuff like that. So, putting a lot of effort and detail into it. Just have another really nice truck. I love this truck. Courtesy of the Truck Sim guys that model every component of this. Close to detail they put into their trucks. The only thing most people do is really do a hack job edits. But anyways, I really like this one, pretty authentic. Also working on a T800. Basically, all that's different is the frame's a little bit longer frame with a lift axle and a different hood. Another thing is I redid the train spline, so the train should come over on these tracks. It takes a while to go around the whole map. expanded that grassy patch up at 25 just to maximize total acreage in those fields. Put all these power lines down here. These backcountry roads. I made this dirt road just because I wanted a different look. I was kind of sick of all this pavement. Most back roads in Wisconsin are paved, but I wanted something a little different. So I was kind of concerned how much mobility we would have over here at this grain bin running tandem trailer. So I just kind of bumped out my turning radius, give us a little bit extra about 650 liters of barley left. We have a god awful lot of corn. We actually pulled in more barley than soybeans. It's always nice when you have a lot of grain to sell. So if we had 236ers, we'd probably be moving close to 170,000 liters with two trucks. If they're both running the dual 36s. But we're not, so. About just 8:13 in the morning here. I like this real time because it actually has the real time of my clock on here. So we're in the market coming up for a big tractor. So I really can't decide between a Cat Challenger, between a John Deere 9RT, and between a T9 700 ATI. You guys should comment below and suggest what kind of big tractor you want to see running the grain cart and our tillage equipment, because or like even a John Deere 9R. Honestly, I can't decide. So just let us know what kind of big tractor you'd like to see. Articulator tractors, the big ATI doesn't really like the GPS on 26, but I highly doubt that thing's going to be going 26 with a GPS. It's not like it's going to be pulling a DN. So. But it is nice for plowing. It picks up the GPS sign really nice. Tracked kitty pulls really nice. I think the T9 700's got more horsepower than the Big Cat, and has more horsepower than the John Deere. My 9RX and the other big 9R, new 9R, they're not really up to standards yet. I haven't really worked on them. I just made them bump the body, but the scripting on them is not really up to server standards, so those really won't be considered until I find time to improve those. But right now it's between the Kitty, the 9RT, and T9 700. I almost want to use the T9 700 because honestly, although I made it, I haven't really used it. So, and we have everything else new hauling on here, and we pretty much clogged, you know, damn near 28 hours on Kitty, doing all this tillage. So, we use Kitty quite a bit. And then if we were going to go with the 9RT, you know, we got a nice John Deere tillage equipment, DN spreaders, planters, if you're into that color matching kind of reasoning. So hopefully selling all this grain will cover our cost of production. We had about 250,000 in seed leases and all that stuff last year, and we're gonna have about 400,000 this year. So hopefully we make enough money to cover our last year's expense, which we obviously will, and then give us enough at least get us to the next great demand where we can unload more grain and rent some planters and get the seed in the ground and still be in the black and not have to take out any more loans. So that's kind of the what I'm hoping for, really. Hopefully we can make another 200,000 or so off this crop. I think it was valued anywhere from like 300 to 600 or 700,000. I had to look on my Excel sheet to see what our projected figures were. So we know the yield, we know the prices of a lot of things, we know how much it costs to put in nutrients, we know how much nutrients it takes, each field takes. So we know pretty much we can pretty much predict the cost of putting in a crop in the ground and what kind of nutrients. And we can also predict the yield, and we can also predict the price, so we can predict our profit. So we can really kind of like maximize our operation. So we planted our best, most profitable crop, which is actually corn, on our most expensive ground. What we should really do is put our most, we should do alfalfa on our most expensive ground, because it's by far the most profitable crop that we can per acre. It's also the least amount of work really to maintain. But now we put corn on our expensive ground, and then our next most profitable is beans, and then we put barley. But barley is there's only two crops accepted at Budweiser. Well, three. There's oat, wheat, and barley. So the chances of a great demand on one of those three crops is extremely high. So that's why we went with the barley. And so it's kind of a surprise that we have a great demand where we're going with barley. So, but that's the rationale behind going with barley. Although it's not as profitable, there's a really high probability that we're going to hit a great demand with it, so we don't have to sit on our grain as long as we normally would. As we wind down here, probably have three more trips after this. I think this will be trip number four. Overall, pretty happy with the performance of these trailers. I pulled the rear suspension specs from the man truck in game and put on these trailers, so the wheels are a little bit more stiff and not as squishy. So the capacity of this setup isn't really what I'd like it to be. Definitely think I'm gonna go with the 4 36-foot trailers, just because it handles a lot nicer. It's two extra axles on the ground, and that's a lot more braking power and a lot more displacement with the weight. But for now, this is working just fine. Could actually have gone with another pup on that second, but if you're running two dual trailers with following mod, it's kind of difficult to unload and stuff like that. But the server, if we had another guy helping, it'd be pretty easy. We'd probably be done by now. This would probably be our last load if it was a server, because we'd be able to go a lot faster. Each person would be able to handle their own machine.